Today we are going to have a lesson about market failure and externalities. In our previous lessons, we have covered in detail what is meant by economic efficiency and its types, like allocative efficiency, productive efficiency. So how can we say there is going to be market failure? What can be the definition of the market failure? How can we develop our understanding about this topic? I would rather say market failure means when the market forces of demand and supply, they are not able to achieve economic efficiency. Clear? When market forces of demand and supply, they are unable to achieve economic efficiency, or any economic inefficiency of the market forces of demand and supply is the reason of market failure. Clear? Now I will give you the examples about the economic inefficiency of the market forces of demand and supply. So first reason you have studied in your AS7, that is about non-provision of public goods. Remember? What do you mean by the public goods? They are collectively used goods by all the people in the society. They are having the definition of non-excludability and non-rivalry, and there is going to be a free rider problem. Like, they are non-excludable means we cannot exclude anybody from the use of the public goods, like roads, like defense, like street lighting. And one person, if he or she is using the public good, it is still available for the other users as well. Alright? So in case of public goods, what is happening? Look here. There is going to be the missing market. What do you mean by missing market? This can be the demand, diagram of the public goods, where we are finding the missing market. There is neither demand is there, but we are not drawing it is downward sloping or supply is upward sloping. So there is going to be a missing market about the public goods. So public goods are actually the economic inefficiency of the market forces of demand and supply. None of the producer in the private sector is going to supply the public goods. Or in other words, I say, resources are not allocated in the production of public goods. There is going to be allocative inefficiency as far as the public goods are concerned. Public goods are not there. So this is the allocative inefficiency. The resources, land, labor, capital, they are not allocated, or there is allocative inefficiency of the market forces of demand and supply to have public goods in the society or in the country. Clear or not? So this can be the one reason of the market failure, where you find economic inefficiency of the market forces. The second reason of market failure, you can see merit and demerit goods. Merit goods are actually those goods which are associated with benefits, and consumers are having information failure about these benefits. By themselves, consumers are not realizing the benefits of these goods, so a third party will play the role of very judgment. So merit goods, I said in our AS lesson, that they are under provided, there is going to be under allocation of resources. So can I say, in case of merit goods, what is going to happen? There is again allocative inefficiency. Resources are not fully allocated, and consumers should buy this product more in quantity if they are provided sufficient information about the benefits of merit goods. So in case of merit codes, we studied what the market forces are having allocative inefficiency. That's why we say this is also a reason of market failure. What about the demerit codes? The demerit codes are having over allocation of resources. Again, the consumers are not realizing the full harmful effects of the demerit codes. What are the demerit codes? Smoking a cigarette, drinking wine, or anything which is harmful to the consumers, but they do not realize by themselves. Can I say nowadays internet can be a demerit good if it is overutilized by the students at the time of their exams?
Yes.
This can be. They are not realizing that by using more and more internet on their phones, they are having a huge opportunity cost, because tomorrow or day after tomorrow they are going to appear in their final exam and they are overusing the internet just for social networking. Alright. So the use of anything which is going to be harmful to the consumers and they do not realize that, so that becomes a demerit. Okay? So in cyber world we can say internet can be one of the demerit when this is used for non-productive purposes where we are not having any productivity of internet. So in that case social marketing or whatsoever say social connectivity can harm the future of the students, then it can be a demerit good. So we can say there is going to be over allocation of resources in the production of demerit goods. Okay, so market failure is the reason of economic inefficiency either in the form of public goods or in the form of merit goods or demerit goods. There can be another example of market failure, that is the presence of monopoly. We will study that in detail in chapter number 8. How monopoly is going to cause the market failure. Keep it in mind, when allocative efficiency is not achieved, I explained to you, there is going to be dead weight loss. Do you remember the dead weight loss or welfare loss? When production, there is under production or overproduction, there can be the welfare losses in the market due to the overproduction or allocative inefficiencies. Like some goods are overproduced, I gave you this example, if you remember over here. This is a demand and supply of product. When it is under supply, so this area is showing us the dead weight loss. Consumer surplus and producer surplus losses is called for dead weight loss. Okay, so welfare losses are arising due to allocative inefficiencies. Clear? So we say allocated inefficiencies are causing the market failure. ये जो एरिया ना देखिए यहाँ पे क्या है, यहाँ पे कंज्यूमर सरप्लस एंड प्रोड्यूसर सरप्लस लॉस है. इफ यू रिमेंबर द टैक्सेशन, वी डिड द टैक्सेस इन आवर मार्केट फॉर सर्टेन इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेस, सो दे वर कॉजिंग द डेड वेट लॉस. सो व्हेन प्रोडक्ट्स आर अंडर प्रोड्यूस दे आर आल्सो कॉजिंग द डेड वेट लॉस. यू कैन से द शुगर इज अंडर सप्लाइड इन आवर कंट्री नाउ डेज, सो दे आर हार्मिंग द वेलफेयर ऑफ द कंज्यूमर्स एज वेल. क्लियर? So any type of inefficiency is the reason of the market failure. Now come towards the topic for today, that is externalities and market failure. How externalities are going to cause the market failure in the society? Without any without any payment or price, like nobody has paid any price for these effects. For example, when producer is producing the leather garments, leather jackets, they are using a tannery to produce these things. But along with the leather jackets, he is also dumping the waste material into clean drinking water. There is going to be air pollution or water pollution or noise pollution created by the producers of leather garments or any producer who is producing the goods for the consumers. But along with that, he is also creating pollution for the society. Do you think anyone has paid for that pollution which is borne by the society? Have you paid for that? None of us is going to pay for that pollution, but we are affected without any payment. We are paying to buy the leather jackets, leather garments, whatsoever we want to buy, but we haven't paid for the pollution created by the producers of those products. So this is what the spillover effect of producing leather garments to the society or third party without any payment and without pricing, that is called externality. What is the price of that pollution in the market? Can we measure it by using the market mechanism of demand and supply? Market forces are failed to measure the value of that negative externality. That's why we say the externalities are also the reason of the market failure. They are also causing allocative inefficiencies, and they are the reasons of the market failure. Another example of externality is that is about the fragrance of your garden to your neighbors.
Sir, is there allocated
efficiency or something in efficiency? So, if I say you are maintaining your own garden at your home, but its fragrance is also enjoyed by your neighbors, have they paid for that scenic beauty or that fragrance which they are enjoying? So this is what you are positively causing a spillover effect to the society without any payment. You are paying for your own private benefit. You are getting the private benefit of that garden. You are enjoying that scenic beauty. But your neighbors are also getting the benefit of that without any payment. So this is also a spillover effect which is going to the society without any payment or without any price. So externalities, they are actually the external effects or spillover effects of an economic activity to the society or to the third party without any payment. So these are called the externalities, which are also the outcomes of any economic activity. Okay, I can give you another example of Wi-Fi. You are having your own Wi-Fi connection and you are having it open for everyone. You are getting the private benefit of that Wi-Fi connection, but other people are also getting the benefit without any payment. So an open connection of Wi-Fi, which is provided by you to other people without any payment, that is a positive externality which you are creating in the society. Any question, Alina? Okay. Now I am moving into the details of this topic of externalities. What are the different types of externalities? There are two types actually. One is called positive externalities and another is called negative externalities. There are two types. One is called positive externalities and second is called negative externalities. Definitions are very simple. As I wrote previously, these are the spillover effects. When we talk about positive standards, these are positive spillover effects of an economic activity to the society without any payment. Clear? These are actually the benefits, the external benefits, which are enjoyed by the society members without any payment. or negative spillover effects of an economic activity on the society without any payment. Positive externalities means you are getting vaccinated for COVID-19, so you will not be the reason of spreading COVID-19. The society will be benefited without any payment. So getting vaccinated for COVID-19 is having a positive spillover effect on the society. This can be one of the example of positive externalities. Whereas negative externalities means when one person is going to be the reason of spreading COVID-19. So others are affected without any payment. So that can be a negative externality. Now I am continuously using one word, third party. Who is the first party and second party and then the third party? The economic agents, consumers and producers, they are first and second party. If you are buying something, you are the first one to buy. And seller is going to be the second one to sell it to you. Suppose you are going to buy any cell phone. So you are the first party. You will get the benefit out of it. If you are buying a cell phone, what is happening? Your private benefit will arise because you have paid for it. And seller is also getting the benefit. He is the second party. The third party, who are not involved in this transaction, you are the buyer, seller is going to sell it. The third person, the society members who are not involved in this transaction, if they are affected positively or negatively, they are going to have this spillover effect of externalities. Some products they do not have any spillover effect, like if you are using a cell phone for yourself, is it having any external benefit or external cost to the people?
No.
Until unless it raises its volume and other people are disturbed, then this can be having the negative externality. Otherwise, it is having no external effect to the other people if it is in your personal use. So remember, third party is that which is not involved in buying and selling or in production and consumption of that product, but they are affected without any payment. Clear or not? So when we talk about positive externalities, usually here in this chapter we will be studying positive externalities which are caused by the consumers. Like if you are having a garden, if you are having a free Wi-Fi connection to other people, so actually you, from consumer side, you are benefiting the society. Okay? So positive externalities, they are here created by or originated by the consumers. So there are three types of benefits which are involved in case of positive externalities. What are these three types of benefits? One is called marginal private benefit. What it is? Marginal private benefit. It is written MPB. In abbreviation, marginal private benefit. Second benefit is called marginal external benefit. Marginal external benefit that goes to the society without any payment. Clear? Now the third benefit, that is called marginal social benefit. Now one by one I will explain them, and by that we will be able to complete our lesson about positive externalities. It will take a little bit time. What is the meaning of marginal? That means additional. Private means if you are paying to buy a product, so you are having a private benefit of that. If I am having my own cell phone, this is my private benefit. I paid for it. I will enjoy its benefits. Okay? So marginal means additional. First I am going to explain what is meant by marginal private benefit. This is actually the additional benefit of additional unit purchased by consumer. If you remember the consumer surplus, remember? In our previous lesson of allocative efficiency, I was talking about marginal utility. Remember, marginal utility. For every extra unit you are going to consume, your marginal or additional utility of extra unit will be diminishing. Suppose you are going to have one glass of water, first glass of water will give you more satisfaction. And if you are taking another glass of water at the same time, the satisfaction derived from the second glass will be lower than the first glass of water. And if you are taking the third glass at the same time, its additional utility or additional satisfaction will be lower than the second one. Clear or not? So when we talk about marginal private benefit, how it can be elaborated in the form of a diagram, this is the demand curve of the consumer, which is representing what? Marginal private benefit of consumer. What does it represent?
Marginal
private benefit. How? This is the price. For the first unit, the consumer is getting this much of marginal utility and marginal private benefit. He is ready to pay a more price for the first unit, but the actual price he is paying, that is lower than the utility gain. So he is enjoying what? The consumer surplus for the first unit. His welfare is high.
The price he is paying is less than
the benefit he or she is receiving for the first unit. So he will be offered another unit, he is buying an extra unit. So the additional unit is having lower marginal private benefit than the first one. And so on. So this demand curve is showing us that the demand curve is actually showing us a marginal private benefit of the consumer as he is going to buy the successive units. Every successive unit will have lower satisfaction than the previous unit, and his willingness to pay will also be decreasing for the next unit. By your first unit of commodity, if you are buying and you are getting more satisfaction, you are ready to pay more. For the second unit, if your satisfaction is lower, so you will be ready to pay less for the second unit. Clear or not? So marginal private benefit, private means which goes to the consumer himself, and for every extra unit consumed, this additional benefit will be lower than the previous unit. That's why consumer is ready to pay less for every extra unit. That's why we say the demand curve or marginal private benefit of the consumer is downward sloping. He will buy an extra unit when marginal benefit is higher than price, but extra unit, his willingness to pay will also be lower. Okay? So this is called marginal private benefit, which can be represented by the downward sloping demand curve of the consumers. Now what about the external benefit?
Yes.
Okay, marginal external benefit that goes to the society without any payment. This is actually the positive externality. This is going to the society without any payment. Now look here. Please listen. When external benefit is added to the private benefit, the new demand curve will be like this. It will be higher than the previous one. So the gap between these two demand curves, that is marginal external benefit. When we add the external benefit to the private benefit, so the demand will shift rightward. This is one thing. Private benefit is that which you are enjoying by paying the price. Clear? But at the same time, society is also benefited. So when we add the external benefit which goes to the society without payment, so our demand curve will shift towards right. Clear or not?
Yes.
So this new demand curve is called what? Marginal social benefit. So marginal social benefit is actually the sum of marginal private benefit and marginal external benefit. This new demand curve is actually called what? The marginal social benefit. So any product which is having more marginal social benefit than the marginal private benefit, that is having the positive spillover effects, that product is called, it is associated with positive externalities because it is benefiting the society more than the consumer himself. Clear? So manal social benefit is the sum of manal private benefit and marginal external benefit. Now how market will fail? Now I will come towards the market force, the second market force, that is the supply curve. If I draw it over here, now I think this thing, these three benefits are clear to you.
Yes.
Private benefit, external benefit, social benefits. Now this is the externality which is arising from consumer side. Producer of this product is not having any externality, neither positive nor negative. So I say this supply curve is not having any externality. So I will explain to you, this is equal to marginal private cost plus marginal external cost, or we say marginal private cost is equal to marginal social cost. Like it is not having any externality, for the time being, keep it in mind, this supply is representing marginal social cost. Now this is the marginal private benefit, this is T1. Please look at the board. Market will produce Q1 and this price will be charged by the market forces price without considering the external benefit of this product. I will explain in the next strategy, but right now just keep it in mind that producer is not causing any externality, neither positive nor negative. When I will explain this negative externality, I will make it clear to you how, because negative externalities, they are usually coming from the producer side. Okay? Now see, this is the marginal private benefit. Market says you have to pay this price in order to sell this quantity Q1. Because whatever is demanded, that is supplied by the producers or sellers by the that product. Clear? If you remember the positive economics means we deal with the economic facts. Fact is that without considering the social effect of this product, privately market is cleared over. But when we talk about normative economics, that is value judgment says as this product is having more social benefit than the private benefit, society says you have to clear the market at Q2. Include this marginal external benefit. We are also benefited because of your decision. If you are having a good garden, so this is not only you who are benefited because of that. Society is also gaining its welfare. So social benefit is more than your private benefit. So society says, as this product is having positive externality, it is beneficial to us as well. You have to produce and consume at Q2, which is a social desirable level of output of this product. Society wants this type of product. This is called social allocative efficiency, where marginal social benefit is equal to marginal social cost. Society says market should not be clearing at E1. Value judgment is that more should be resources allocated in the production of this product, which is having more benefit to the society. Clear? So here, the social desirable level of output is Q2, but market forces are not including this external benefit into it. So they are clearing at Q1. So market is under allocating resources in the production of the goods which are associated with positive externalities. So there is going to be allocative inefficiency. Allocative inefficiency. Resources are under allocated by the producers who have this product. So market desires that, society desires that more should be produced as it is benefiting to the non-payers as well. It is not benefiting only to the consumer himself or herself, but it is benefiting majority of people, so it should be having more production. The social desirable level of output of this commodity should be Q2. More resources should be allocated in the production of this product, which is associated with positive externality. So in this case, can I say market forces are having allocative inefficiency? Can we measure the market price of the fragrance or scenic beauty which is enjoyed by your neighbors? Is there any mechanism? How much is the value of that fragrance? So market forces are failed to measure that external benefit actually. That's why they are not including it into their measurement of prices as well and the level of output. So there is going to be market failure due to positive externalities, because market forces are not measuring the external benefit enjoyed by the society without any payment. That's why market is clearing at Q1, but society wants to have more of this product as it is having more social benefit than the private benefit. So positive externalities, in this case resources are under allocated, there is going to be allocative inefficiency, and in the start I said market failure is the reason of economic inefficiency. So whenever we find allocative inefficiency, either it is due to public goods, merit goods, or due to the positive externalities, there is going to be market failure. Usually the merit goods are associated with positive externalities, like you people are getting education, but society members will also be benefited because of your education. It does not mean that you will only be getting the private benefit, society will also be benefited. So merit goods are associated with positive externalities, so society members will ask you to get further education because they will have a well-trained, educated person in the society without any payment. He's not going to harm to other people, rather he or she is going to give more benefits to the society members. Clear or not? So positive externalities are having allocative inefficiency. This is the reason of market failure. I think it is enough, or should I go further? Thank you for today.